Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's video covers a fracture by Grindavik, or should you say a rift, that caught my attention while I was making a video about the possible scenario that the townspeople could face. And that video has actually aged quite well, so I'm linking to it. But the land by this fracture, it has not aged as well. And we can see how it sunk during the November 10th event. So it is partially under water now. And what I have for you today are two thermal scan tours. The second tour just recently, late October, when the town reopened. But I'm starting with the other tour after the eruption that came up almost in the town and burned down three houses. So I desperately wanted to scan this area with the thermal drone. But the access was very restricted. So when I finally got my chance, I was not in any position to be picky when it comes to weather. So this became one of those special occasions when I complained about too much sunshine in Iceland. But the scan, it turned out to be a good exercise because despite the sub-zero temperature, stones that were exposed to the sunlight were glowing like a Christmas tree decoration. And as for the thermal drone, it is a learning curve that I'm going through, or to sort out what is normal or not. And I was not alone there. Amanda Jo, that often appears on the geology channel that Professor Sean Wilson runs, she was there to help me. And flying over this fracture, we both got a bit confused for a while, so we did a little walkabout to see if the rocks around the fracture were actually as hot as they appeared on the thermal scan. And it was indeed the sun that was bluffing the thermal camera. The contrasts against the cold ground, they just appeared stronger than we expected. But the fracture itself, it is around 25 meters deep and it is the home of sticklebacks and eels. And the water surface there, it follows the tides. So it's all fresh water there during low tide. And the thermal scan turned out to be extremely difficult with the sun shining. But I decided to keep the video and use it later. And I actually filmed more back then, mostly aiming the drone at the fractures by the graben that formed during the November 10th event. And the only anomalies I found had to do with repair projects, pipelines and such. But at least I learned how sensitive the camera is. Like, I could see warm lava very clearly, even kilometers away. And when the town opened again, I was one of the first visitors, early morning, in order to be there before the sun might start teasing me again. And that scanning tour, it turned out to be way easier. So the anomalies I detected, they popped out way better. And this time I could clearly see that the water was clearly warmer in the fracture and we can also see how it's blending in with the water in the pond. But as for the temperature difference, I ran into technical problems. I do have a spot thermometer on the drone that has turned out to be very accurate if I'm not too far away. But every now and then it looks as it needs a calibration, although it seems to get the temperature difference right. So that is something that I need to look at. Usually, this problem just goes away after a few minutes. But that day, I had a bit more problems than usual. But knowing the drone already, and after looking over the files that I came back with, I am quite sure that the water in this fracture is around 10 degrees warmer than the water in the pond. And if this area around the fracture wasn't restricted that day, I would have gone there with another thermometer I have, and as you must know, I'm not a geologist, so I'm not an expert when it comes to groundwater temperature anomalies on the plate boundaries. And this warmer groundwater, it might just be normal. It might very well be that it has always been like this. And I can't say if the ongoing series of events are warming up the groundwater somewhere on the way to the sea. And I'm not even sure if experts can say, but I did however look up numerous old reports and tales about this location, and I didn't find anything usable about the groundwater temperature in this fracture. That is actually named Silvergjá, that can be translated into silver rift or fissure. And the legend has it that there is a chest full of silver deep down there. And those who have managed to dive down and bring it up to the surface, they have all witnessed the same. Or the nearby farms seemingly burning, causing the treasure hunters to panic, so they were never able to get the silver all the way up from the fracture, where it still is. But what is, however, more visible now is the fact that the groundwater from under the peninsula emerging there is a bit warmer than the water that is in the pond. And I'm not sure if it has any meaning for the channel to follow up on this, but it's always useful to have those thermal images to look at later if something new happens around there. So this location will remain on my thermal drone filming list because we know that this area is not in the clear yet. And as always, I will be looking at the comment section. But as for me, thermal footage is always fun to shoot and a big part of my drive force in photography and videography comes from the fact that modern equipment sees better than me and all of us. And as for the next eruption, I'm sticking to December 1st or there around, but it would not surprise me if I would have to cover some perhaps quite big news even before that. And it might not be an eruption, it might be an earthquake or an earthquake swarm, and I'm more or less talking about the anomalies I see on the seismometers today. Looks like one of those pulses where we see increased seismic activity covering almost the whole country. And that might go on for even several days. I see this every now and then. And this weekend, it looks unusual, especially when it comes to Bárðarbunga volcano and actually other systems under Vatnajökull glacier as well. And then we have this situation in West Iceland, where we might be seeing one of the surprises of the year in the making. But I might be wrong, of course. I'm just speculating, although this looks to me as one of the weekends that I will be looking at the seismometers a bit more often than usual. And I wish you a happy weekend with best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.